world's largest and most powerful space telescope has revealed unprecedented views of Jupiter.
Researchers have located the perfect solar system.
The presence of life and other forms of organic matter outside our planet has always been a topic of great interest. For centuries, scientists have made several studies and variations on what we might just find existing on planets and bodies many million miles away from us. In a recent mission, Juno, a solar-powered spacecraft, made a groundbreaking discovery on Ganymede, the largest moon in our solar system. This is a big leap in solving the mystery. Did we finally find other forms of life on a moon? Join us on a voyage to space as we explore the details of Juno's terrifying discovery. A new discovery on Ganymede. NASA's Juno mission has recently made groundbreaking discovery of mineral salts and organic compounds on the surface of Jupiter's moon, Ganymede. Data for this discovery was collected by the Jovian InfraRed Auroral Mapper spectrometer aboard the spacecraft during a close flyby of the icy moon, reaching a minimum altitude of 650 miles, less than the distance between New York and Chicago. With this new finding, which was published on the 30th of October, scientists at NASA are optimistic that they can now finally understand the origin of Ganymede and the composition of its deep oceans. During this encounter, the JERAM instrument captured infrared images and spectra of the moon's surface. NASA said that the data achieved an unprecedented level of detail, with a spatial resolution of better than 0.62 miles per pixel. This allowed scientists to detect and analyze the unique spectral features of non-water ice materials, including hydrated sodium chloride, ammonium chloride, sodium bicarbonate, and possibly aliphatic aldehydes. These materials are likely the residue of salty seawater from an underground ocean that bubbled up to the frozen surface of Ganymede. And excitingly, a salty ocean indicates conditions there might be conducive to life. Unlike many other moons, Ganymede is a particularly special place. Not only is it Jupiter's most massive satellite, it's the biggest moon in the whole solar system. It's even larger than the planet Mercury. It's also the only moon to have its own magnetic field, generated from a molten metal core deep in its interior. Like other icy worlds of the outer solar system, such as Europa or possibly Pluto, Ganymede probably has an ocean lurking under its icy crust. Some studies suggest multiple seas, stacked together in a layer cake of ice sheets and oceans hidden underground. Because Ganymede is so big, its interior structure is more complicated than that of smaller worlds. The moon's massive size means there's a lot of space for interesting molecules to mix about. But that also means they're tricky to spot, because material must cover a large distance to get to the surface where our spacecraft can see them. Importantly, material on the surface of Ganymede might tell us about the water hiding below. If there are salts above, the subsurface ocean might have that same brine. Oceans, including the ones on Earth, acquire their salt from chemical interactions, where liquid water touches a rocky mantle. According to Federico Tosi, research scientist at the National Institute for Astrophysics, this kind of exchange is one of the conditions necessary for habitability. However, other current research suggests that Ganymede doesn't have a liquid water layer directly touching its mantle. Instead, icy crusts separate the ocean from the rock. But because the team did see these salts in the JERAM data, it suggests they were touching at one point in the past, if not now. Other Jovian worlds. Each of the Jovian planets has a number of moons, although Jupiter has the most with more than 60 cataloged to date. Jupiter's four largest moons exhibit some of the most interesting geology in the solar system. They were discovered by Galileo Galilei and are known as the Galilean moons. Jupiter's largest moon, Ganymede, is larger than Mercury, while the other three are larger than Pluto. Previous modeling of Ganymede's magnetic field determined the moon's equatorial region, up to a latitude of about 40 degrees, is shielded from the energetic electron and heavy ion bombardment created by Jupiter's hellish magnetic field. The presence of such particle fluxes is well known to negatively impact salts and organics. According to NASA, during the June 2021 flyby, Jovian covered a narrow range of latitudes of about 10 degrees north to 30 degrees north and a broader range of longitudes of about minus 35 degrees east to 40 degrees east in the Jupiter-facing hemisphere. Great abundance of salts and organics were found in the dark and bright terrains at latitudes protected by the magnetic field, according to Scott Bolton, Juno's principal investigator from the Southwest Research Institute in San Antonio, which suggests the remnants of a deep ocean brine that reached the surface of this frozen world. Ganymede is not the only Jovian world Juno has flown by. The moon Europa, thought to harbor an ocean under its icy crust, also came under Juno's gaze, first in October 2021 and then in September 2022. Now Io is receiving the flyby treatment. The next close approach to that volcano-festooned world is scheduled for December 30, when the spacecraft will come within 932 miles of Io's surface. The Voyager spacecraft took the first close-up images of Io more than 300 years after the moon's discovery. The images showed a surface with no signs of craters from past impacts. What scientists saw instead was a surface almost entirely covered with large volcanoes. Cameras on Voyager actually captured volcanic eruptions in progress. The frequency of these sulfuric eruptions has filled in almost all of the impact craters and left Io with one of the youngest looking surfaces in the solar system. Although there is no direct evidence of tectonic activity on Io, scientists feel confident it exists, since the processes that fuel volcanism also fuel tectonics. The volcanic eruptions are so frequent and cover the surface so thoroughly that any clear evidence of tectonic activity is likely to be buried. Why scientists are interested in Jupiter? Scientists cannot understand the origin of the solar system or how the Earth and life came about without understanding how Jupiter formed. There is still a lot that is yet to be known about Jupiter, like what it is made of, what lies beneath those beautiful swirling clouds, and what exactly drives its magnetic field. Experts think that giant planets like Jupiter are the cornerstones of planet formation. These planets were assembled early in the process, before their young stars had the chance to absorb or blow away the light gases in the huge cloud from which they were born. Giant planets also play a big role in planet formation, because their huge masses allow them to shape the orbits of other objects in their planetary systems, such as other planets, asteroids, and comets. Although scientists have pieced together the basic story of Jupiter's origin, some important questions remain, and Juno's mission is to help us answer them. Exactly how early was Jupiter born? Jupiter might have formed at its current orbit, but some evidence also suggests that it could have formed farther from the Sun before migrating inward. Because Jupiter formed at the same time as the Sun, their chemical compositions should be similar. But Jupiter has more heavy elements, such as carbon and nitrogen, than the Sun. Competing formation theories make different predictions about the content and mass of Jupiter's core, so measuring the core will allow us to eliminate ideas that are wrong. Determining the amount of water, and therefore oxygen, in the gas giant is important not only for understanding how the planet formed, but also how heavy elements were transferred across the solar system. These heavy elements were crucial for the existence of rocky planets like Earth and life. Juno and Jovian. Juno is a United States space probe designed to orbit the planet, Jupiter. It is the second project in NASA's New Frontiers program of solar system missions, of which the first was New Horizons. It has been very pivotal in NASA's research on the Jupiter and its moons, including the discovery of large cyclones near the planet's poles, determining that Jupiter accreted from large, kilometer-sized planetesimals instead of from much smaller centimeter-sized objects, as well as the NASA's newest discovery of minerals and salts on Jupiter's largest moon. The probe is named for a Roman goddess, the female counterpart to the god Jupiter. Juno was launched by an Atlas V rocket from Cape Canaveral, Florida, on August 5, 2011. On October 9, 2013, it flew by Earth for a gravity boost on its journey to Jupiter, where it arrived on July 4, 2016. Juno orbits Jupiter every 11 days in a highly elliptical orbit over the planet's poles. Unlike previous probes to the outer solar system, Juno is solar-powered. Because of Jupiter's distance from the Sun, Juno's three arrays of solar panels total more than 20 meters in length. Juno carries several instruments to study Jupiter's auroras, magnetosphere, atmosphere, gravitational field, and largest moons, Ganymede, Europa, Callisto, and Io. Although the main spacecraft was built by Lockheed Martin, Juno's instruments and components came from all over the world. Juno shipped in pieces to the Kennedy Space Center in Florida, where it was assembled and put on top of an Atlas V 551 rocket that blasted it off into space. While building the spacecraft, engineers took extreme care to keep it clean. They worked in a clean room and wore special suits that prevent dirt, dust, and hair from contaminating the craft. Engineers tested every part of the spacecraft to ensure that it survives the harsh environment of outer space. They simulated the conditions that Juno may encounter in test chambers. For example, they tested how well components can withstand heat and vibration, a test often called shake and bake. Amongst the instruments carried on the Juno spacecraft is JIRAM, Jovian InfraRed Auroral Mapper. Built by the Italian space agency, Agenzia Spaziale Italiana, JIRAM was designed to capture the infrared light, invisible to the naked eye, that emerges from deep inside Jupiter, probing the weather layer down to 30 to 45 miles below the gas giant's cloud tops. But the instrument has also been used to offer insights into the terrain of moons Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, known collectively as the Galilean moons for their discoverer, Galileo. The Jovian Infrared Auroral Mapper, JIRAM, is a dual instrument composed of an imager and a spectrometer that share the same telescope. This allows for acquisition of simultaneous imaging and spectral observations. The imager is equipped with L-band filters for aurora observations and M-band filters for observations of thermal emissions. The instrument was designed to map the Jovian aurora, taking advantage of strong methane absorption in the atmosphere, which results in H3++ appearing bright against the dark planet. Combining this IR data with corresponding ultraviolet data from the UVS spectrograph provides a powerful tool for understanding the auroral formation. The dual capability of JIRAM allows for detailed mapping and probing the atmosphere. The analysis of Jupiter's auroras is one of the main scientific objectives for which JIRAM was built. Among the various molecular ions that undergo emission in Jupiter's aurora, only H3+ emits powerful in the JIRAM spectral range. The JIRAM instrument was designed to investigate the H3+ infrared emission and will be able to furnish spatial, spectral, and temporal distribution of the Jovian auroras. With the combination of powerful tools such as Juno and JIRAM, space exploration becomes accurate and a lot more optimistic than ever before. It comes without a doubt that as scientific research furthers on, we are likely to see more interesting discoveries in the coming future. On Juno's trip over Jupiter's massive moons, do you think we will discover more interesting things? Leave your comments below. Also, like this channel and subscribe to be up to date with the latest contents.